coming towards us.
Oh my God. Look at all this stuff. This is a new one, a sewing machine.
Like, it's just kind of liquidy in there.
Guys, it is the time of the year again where we go to all the stores, show off all the different spooky merchandise. We're starting here at Joann's. We're going to go to a bunch of different places today. Also, we're going to stop by Disney. I'm wearing my Nickelodeon Halloween shirt. Let's head into Joann's first.
Joann, handmade happiness.
Little scarecrows in a timeout, it looks like. We have bags of little silver skulls and then little bat and a black cat, little succulents. Little pink skull and this little judgmental pumpkin. I was asking all the workers and they were saying everybody keeps calling to see when all the Halloween merchandise is out. People are just going wild this year for all the Halloween decorations. We're starting in July. Time mid-August comes around, everything is sold out. If you were here in Orlando, all the stores that we're kind of going to today are kind of located on 192.
$30, you can get some skeleton little oven mitts.
This mug says, say witch, like it's a bad thing. Having a Halloween party, you don't want to keep stuff year-round. They just have standard little napkins or paper plates. We have a little trio of ceramic pumpkins, a bunch of little decorative hand towels, decorative stands that are like spider webs, a little ghost, another little candy display, creepy little metal spider. We have some doormats, welcome to our web, some skulls, shoes off witches. This family is a little baddie. This is a great one. It's like the black pumpkin. A little pumpkin family right here. Oh, I love the oranges on this little doormat. A little ghost coming out of the haunted house. Standard fun little ghost family just says boo. Haunted Acres, Dead and Breakfast. Please book ahead. Stay for a spell.
Or just decorative little ceramic Halloween decorations.
A decorative yard stake eek sign. Then we have a witch's hat, a spider down there. And then kind of just like some standard little pumpkins. And then I like this haunted house with the bats coming out. Little springs to the bats. Then down here we have some more light up skulls with a raven on top. Then for $500, I got an 8 foot tall skeleton where its eyes light up. Some decorative, this almost looks like it could be a trash can, but they have a black skull and they have plastic light up giant skulls and pumpkins. $130, it's a light up ghost. Oh. We have a bunch of the little light up LEDs. So you have a skull, a witch hat, a ghost, a bat, a little pumpkin. And this one is a little bit bigger. It's like a ghost coming out of a candle. And then we have a light up boo sign. Bunch of skeleton hands. You know when like oil is in water, that rainbow shine to it. There's some skeletons and flamingos. Skeleton flamingos. This is probably 3 foot tall skeletons. They're about $40 a piece. But this is really cool. It's like a giant skeleton, giant orange skeleton, probably about 5 feet tall, but it's got like a pumpkin face. We have a bunch of different types of skeletons. You have skeletons of pumpkins. Didn't realize there was a skeletal structure to pumpkins. Some little dogs. They got Christmas stuff out already. Giant metal signs that says boo, and there's a witch making a potion. This kind of looks like the little moon in the middle of Cosmic Rewind when you're going around it on the coaster. It's like snake is crawling through the skull. Whole wall of just kind of those decorative display boxes that a lot of people like to put around their house. The moon made me do it. A bunch of little like mini just decorative cauldrons. Do some little fortune telling. You say witch like it's a bad thing. Here's an eye and then a little mirror right there. Massive cauldron. This thing is ceramic and pretty big. This is like just a blacked out haunted house that lights up. I like the little hints and accents of orange on it. Just a simple little display box. I'm a haunt mess. These are all ceramic. All these kind of light up. We have skeletons, little spooky Christmas trees, some witch hats that light up. Happy Halloween. Part of a skull that's been broken off. You can hang this on a wall. Some light up metal, little disco bat. Ghouls just want to have fun. A moth. More of the little velvet pumpkins. So you can see they're still setting everything up. So we have like the little diagram for how they're supposed to set up the store. We have a metal ghost. Here's like a metal boo sign. And then like some velvet skeleton. This is a new one, a sewing machine with skeleton hands. It's like a raven, but you can kind of see the skeletons of his insides. There's a little red light on the inside. Book of Fright. See like some spiders and the skeleton. The eyes light up on this. It's like a rat rod. Got some very decorative skulls. There's kind of a standard like matte black skull, a little bit of gold. Raven on top of this skull. This is like a skeleton. I guess he loves his books. His eyes light up. Here's another one just kind of relaxing next to a pumpkin. The little pumpkin lights up though. Then here's a little Florida skeleton by the beach having a little drink. It's like a husband and wife going to the underworld. It looks like the front little lantern lights up. The gnomes
They're here.
It's like a giant planter, but it looks like witch boots. A proposing skeleton. And then we have, again, we saw a lot of these last year. One just sitting on the toilet. It's like a couple taking a bath inside their relatives. That's weird. That we have a skeleton falling asleep. He's like sleeping, reading a book. One just dreaming about the afterlife. A little bubble bath skeleton. This almost looks like the hood ornament, but it's like a skeleton doing yoga. Another one meditating. Then we have a little skeleton couple. This guy playing a guitar next to a tombstone. We have like some giant bows that light up. A witch bow. And then over here, you have a skeleton bow that lights up. We got some skulls. Some light up boo signs.
So they're not fully stocked in Joann's. Probably within the next week, everything will be fully out and it'll sell out really quick. But I want to get something to eat real quick. So let's go on a little pit stop and head to
Animal Kingdom. We're here to get a special little green little treat. We're also gonna see Jared, see a couple little updates. And then we'll head back to all the spooky store stuff.
They have a brand new Disney's Animal Kingdom collection. We're here in the merchandise shop right now. The brand new spirit jersey, same camo design. And then right here is gonna be a little hidden Mickey. Wild About Disney, $40, and they have a matching bucket hat. $30, they have this kind of a plastic fanny pack, but this thing is huge. This thing feels more like a backpack than a fanny pack. Then we have a short sleeve hoodie for $45 with that same design. You need some Croc flip-flops. They got those, $40. $40, and they have a tank top, Wild with Minnie right there. $40 for this short sleeve shirt. And then we have leggings with the same camo design for $40. And then $19.99 for a hair accessory set. You got some clips. There's a new Encanto lounge fly. It says on the bottom, it says being strong is fabulous, and it's got a little weight. And then on the back of the lounge fly, she's picking up the donkey. $78. They have another lounge fly with Mickey. He's greeting you, walking you into the castle. There's fireworks going off with a little Tinkerbell all the way at the top. $248 for this new Lion King bag. Oh gosh. What? Why is that going off when you touch it? And then $318, they have another larger bag. And then $328, they have a purse. They also have matching ears for $45. They got a new Animal Kingdom lounge fly. It's like a cheetah print. It's gonna be $78. Kind of look inside the print, you can see little hidden Mickeys. $40, they got some new Jungle Book ears. It's kind of like a little burlap bow. And then on the back, you have some of the other characters. Kevin is out. Now Disney better get ready, because you know that guy who jumped the fence at Busch Gardens is be coming for this crocodile right down here at Animal Kingdom. See how the construction looks in Chester and Hester's, and nothing. Nothing's happening. Got some just kind of leftover benches throughout the park they just kind of threw over here. Now the bird show is about to begin.
The sky will come alive with color as a variety of vibrant macaws join together.
Definitely a green winged macaw.
Time to get our special little treat. It's gonna be here at Starbucks. It's gonna be at the location called Creature Comforts. It's kind of off to the left side of the park before you kind of go over the bridge to Africa. It's located over here, but this is where the special little Heimlich brownie is.
Like this sign, it's like two little monkeys drinking cups of coffee. So you just come up here and you pick up the little brownie, little tough to be a bug brownie, little Heimlich. Which one should we go with?
This Casper did something incredible. It's such a great little magical moment. But as you know, my name is Kevin, right? She drew Kevin, the bird from up, on my Starbucks drink. Now, my go-to Starbucks drink in the parks is a Trenta strawberry lemonade refresher with light ice. Has to be light ice, because they normally fill that sucker all the way up with ice. And you gotta do it lemonade, it adds a little sweetness. But this might be one of the cutest little desserts I think Disney has ever made. The base is gonna be a brownie. It's gonna be a golden brownie, Heimlich on top of his throne. You have some wonderful little sugared flowers with some frosting on top. This is just wonderfully done. This is like Disneyland level stuff. Now this is always the hardest part, kind of cutting into the Zerg. I'm literally murdering Heimlich. Poor little Heimlich has been cut in half. There's like some filling on the inside. I was not expecting that. Let's see what the filling is first. Is that kind of like a cheesecake? All right, let's get a little bit of frosting. If every caterpillar tastes like this, I wouldn't mind eating caterpillars. I think it's a sugar overload. All right, so we finished. Very sugary, very sweet. Is it the best brownie I've ever had? No, but because it's the cutest brownie I've ever had, I'm gonna do like an 8 out of 10 on it. Solid little treat. I think if you're in Animal Kingdom, stop by, get the little tough to be a bug. I'm like, brownie. I don't know why they didn't call it Heimlich brownie. They called it tough to be a bug. Let's go ask some of my friends some caterpillar facts.
Give us a fun nature fact about caterpillars.
Cute. Fun fact about caterpillars, I don't know any besides that they turn into beautiful butterflies.
That when caterpillars go through metamorphosis and turn into chrysalis, chrysalis is for butterflies and cocoons are for moths. That's the difference. When they turn into a chrysalis, they basically turn into goo, like it's just kind of liquidy in there. And then those exact same molecules or whatever that the caterpillar was that turn into goo, then somehow turn into the butterfly.
I got them loaded up. Caterpillars have 4,000 muscles. Number two, caterpillars have 12 eyes. Number three, caterpillars can eat up to 100 times more than their body weight. And number four, caterpillars can kill humans. They're toxic. It's not good. Caterpillars can produce silk, therefore the next Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse will have Caterpillar Man.
Well, now you guys know a little more about caterpillars and butterflies. So on that note,
it's time to leave Animal Kingdom and head to
At Home Store, the home decor superstore.
Now this place is wild. There's so much you're about to see.
Uh-oh, they already have stuff out for Thanksgiving.
They have a bunch of solar-powered, like bobbleheads. See, Freddy Krueger, Pennywise, these are just creepy.
And then we have Jason Misting Lab Beaker.
Oh, the books move in and out? Oh.
If you dare.
It's coming towards us.
Slowly but surely.
Okay. I talk? Try me. This looks like a bunch of roots, like some ravens in the center of it. And then for $55, have the massive neon green. Who was doing this with the skeleton? But they have these here. They all glow in the dark. Welcome to our haunted farmhouse. This looks like that creepy animatronic that we saw out front. It says, beware. So we also have some radioactive neon skeletons. Hey, Boo. And then we have a little ghost saying Boo. And down here, we have a little light up ghost. And they have a cute little bat on top of a jack-o'-lantern. Looks like a little trick-or-treat pail. And yes, the gnomes, here they are. And here's a little Dracula. Simple little spooky sign. Which way to the candy? We have too much candy, no one ever. Love you more than candy. Here's that same little girl, but she's at like, she has her own little figure. And these are little like light up boxes with a little Dracula, a spooky black cat. Please park your broom at the door. This is like a Ouija board skull. Witch is welcome. Hocus pocus. Witch is wanted, apply within. It's like a witch holding a spell book. Needs Halloween, I'm a witch all year. There's some more little potion books. Hocus pocus, a little owl. You put a little candle right there. I'm a crystal collecting, tarot card reading, moon admiring kind of girl. Real witch lives here with her little monsters. Then we have some like potions. This is amazing. It's like this melted creepy candle. That's awesome. A horse is grabbing the skeleton's hat. It's like an artisan glass pumpkin. We have all the skeleton little sculptures. We have one drinking beer. Another one on the toilet. Or no, he's just sitting down looking at his laptop. $40. We have this guy driving his tractor and then he put his buddy on the front. Headed to another spooky section. This is just like the skeleton graveyard. Look at all these guys. Some mummy hands. Then we have dragon skeletons, little monkey skeletons, every type of skeleton you could ever imagine that home store has. The two-headed person with no arms is just, his insides light up, that's about it. The two-headed dog for $80. Oh, it's going. Some peace sign skeleton hands that you can stick in the ground. The skeleton's girlfriend is still clinging on to him. Spider skeleton, more little squids. Some bigger skulls. Bunch of skeleton hands that can come out of the ground. Baby velociraptors. I think this is my favorite little skeleton that they have. He's just kind of put them anywhere. Just kind of waving to everybody and welcoming them. Turns four different colors. Oh. This is how Ted looks like after he's passed away. These are bleeding candles. So I guess when you once you light the candle, it looks like they'll start melting and blood will come out probably. This is a really cool pumpkin. Got these like skeletons crawling out of it. We have a larger dog skeleton and like a little puppy skeleton. We have some birds.
some blow-up jack-o'-lanterns. They have a little skeleton dachshund, a little candy corn, that's pretty cute. And a little pumpkin, 3-foot-tall little ghost, and a 3-foot-tall black cat. Just a rainbow of all these little light-up pumpkins. Again, they got a lot more to still put out, so we'll stop by throughout the season. They have all these little decorations, right, where, again, you just kind of hang them up, and they kind of blow in the wind. Simple little Grim Reapers, and they have, like, some little witch ghosts. Their legs dangle. Then we have, like, these little bats. Their wings open up. They kind of dangle, and you can display those. Some standard little ghosties. There's, like, the little silhouette of a witch. Here's, like, some creepy, demonic Grim Reapers. This thing is terrifying. Ew. Ooh, it's like a weird zombie skeleton girl. And just kind of some nice decorative fall time little doormats. Pumpkin is the spice of life. We have a simple little jack-o'-lantern one. These are all pretty cheap too, like 13 bucks. Some spooky eyes looking at you. Welcome to our coven.
Not spooky. Do not disturb. We're watching football.
Trick or treat. Wipe your feet. Creep it real. No costume, no candy. And they have a little display jack. These have been around for a couple years now. There's not much going on. You just kind of hang them up and he'll blow in the wind. $20. They have a matching Zero set. Love the detail that they put on his nose. Then they have some little gravestones. RIP. Little light up Jack Skellington jack-o'-lanterns. A bunch of different more kind of like plastic, larger versions of the little light up Jack faces. And they have some decorative bottles. They have little mini spiders. And they have bigger spiders. I'm arachnophobic, so I hate spiders. So I'm gonna try to leave this section. Some more glassware, skeleton hands holding up. This is a good little wine glass. It's a metal skeleton, so it's got a good bit of heft to it, but he's holding up the wine glass. It's like a little wine glass, but it's got a little blacked out skeleton hand on it. Some skull napkin rings. They got some spooky bat candles. Eerie Estate table runners. That thing's pretty good. This is like a, it's like, again, like a Grim Reaper holding this lantern. It lights up a little candle right there. Got like a raven top of the skeleton's hand. Looks like he's bursting out of the ground. Just a metal decorative pumpkin. And over here we have a bow, a skull on it, some bones. It looks like a husband and wife, kind of a skeleton portrait. Trick or treat. Welcome home, sweet haunted home. And here's a light up skull that you can just put on your wall or your front door. Little rats top of a typewriter. It's like a bedazzled skull. And then over here, like little crystals are growing out of the skull. Skull Christmas tree. Instead of an angel on top, it's a little bat. Skeleton holding a rose, like a skull. And then you can put, it's like a little planter. You put some actual roses or something in. $20 for a spooky little husband and wife snow globe. They have a wife and husband, little black pumpkin. It's like a Victorian styled pumpkin design. There's a little skeleton enjoying his little treat tray. Oh, makes sounds. What does he do? Kind of like a weird, like, Quagmire skeleton. Just kind of like a hard plastic pumpkin. Get a little bat there on the bottom. Black skulls. Looks like a candle or a little treat holder. Grimy. It's like a skull popping out of the book and then a Grim Reaper right there. $17. Potions, brews, and spells with a skeleton. His eyes light up, popping out of the book. Whole bag full of black skulls. Unscented tombstone candle. And over here we have just some little standard little decorations. Don't make me come up there. Tomb, sweet tomb. Welcome to our haunted home. $10, I got like this skeleton hand. I wish it was an actual bell that you could hit. We got a skull with like a glitter black candle coming out of it. Bunch of like black skulls are like plastic. Mouth moves a little bit. They have a ceramic coffin. Looks like the Grim Reaper. That's pretty creepy. Little gargoyle decorations. We got just some fall little leaves. Get all the inflatables. Let's see what we got. Orange and black spider, an 18-foot tall pumpkin reaper. And down here, a 20-foot tall jack-o'-lantern stack. We have a scary black tree. Down here, a 20-foot tall monster. It's just Frankenstein. Then we got a classic here, the 5-foot, the standard pumpkin. They have a bat on a tombstone. Oh, this one's kind of cool. 7-foot tall LED groundbreaking reaper, swirling lights. We have a 7-foot tall skeleton monster. And then we have a 10.5-foot tall Halloween truck. So you got the whole squad there. 5-foot tall pop-up skeleton, 8-foot tall animated reaper. This is 5 feet wide. You have all the Sanderson sisters. We have the Halloween character stack. You have a Winifred, 3.5-foot tall, exclusively at the at-home store, little pumpkin boy skeleton. Purple spider, it's like Jack is pooping on his little pumpkin toilet. These ghosts are telling little ghost stories around the campfire. Then we got the 6-foot turkey, and then a 72-inch spooky tree for 120. I wish they were kind of displayed a little better. We got a giant 65-inch light-up spider for $130. These, like, ghost-stacked tombstones for $150. A boo sign for $90. Oh, my God. Look at all this stuff. I don't see this one out, but they have a little bluey with vampire costume. You know what? Let's just do a whole little montage of all the blown-up inflatables. Matt, stand next to it. Look how big it is.
Back if I were you. Do you not fear the Reaper? You should. At last, you are here. Come right this way. I have so many souls to take. Your soul is next. I smell the stench of rotting souls. Like you've seen a ghost.
Alive! Alive! Behold my creation, an abomination in the eyes of the Creator, but I alone am its master. Subjects for my experiments, perhaps you would be willing. You may become a monster, but oh, what power you will wield. Think of it. No one will ever dare make you do chores again.
$400.
That is a wrap on our little spooky adventure. It is time to go back to the office now.
Okay, now guys, we are back in the office. We're gonna be going to a lot more different spooky stores throughout the next coming weeks and month. Let me know down in the comments what store I should go to next to see if they have like some new Halloween merchandise for you guys. It is just crazy just to see the amount of Halloween merchandise that has just overwhelmed stores now. It used to be just like one little aisle. Now it's like half the freaking store just becomes Halloween. It's awesome. I love it. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button. If you have not already, hit the subscribe button. Join the family.
I love the family.
Because I'm gonna keep you up to date all things spooky and scary around the country. I love you all, and I'll see y'all very soon.
Like, it's just kind of liquidy in there.
It's a pretty big Grim Reaper like sculpture, but it looks like the light lights up and his eyes, I think, light up.